Hello everyone, it is May 4th, 2012, and it's time for another anniversary malware video. And this time we're looking at the infamous Love Letter Worm from the year 2000, 12 years ago. So 12 years ago today, it began wreaking havoc and showing up all over the world, eventually causing over $5.5 billion in damage due to its somewhat destructive nature and also high moddability. So, as you can see, it would arrive on your system as loveletterforyou.txt. It would seem to be coming from a friend, since it uses your Outlook contacts to send itself. So you would probably trust this. You'd be interested to see why your friend was professing his or her love to you. But if you look at it, it is actually just the worm. And it's just in plain text here, not encrypted or anything. And if we change the standard Windows option to hide file extensions, you'll see it ends in VBS, not text, so it is a script. So we have a few test files here that will be overwritten by the original variant of the worm. We have a JPEG file, screenshot from the game Free Space 2. We have an MP3 from Descent 1, pretty cool. And then we have an HTA file, Hello World, a VBS script, Hello World, just a blank VBE file. Delete the .txt extension, doesn't do anything, and then also another blank JS file that doesn't do anything. So we will go ahead and run the worm and see what happens. So as you can see, mass mails itself to your contacts. If you look at it, subject is I love you, kindly check the attached love letter coming from me, and it's the same for all of these. So it'll email itself to all your contacts, which allowed it to spread very quickly. And while it does that, well, you know, maybe we should disable share folders in virtual PC for just a moment, so it doesn't overwrite all my shared folder files. That's a good idea. So anyway, as you can see, it has overwritten a lot of these, except for the VBE file for some reason. See, our MP3 file is now the worm. mp3.vbs, jpeg.vbs. It just overwrote the JS file, didn't even keep the old file extension. testvbs.vbs, it's just the worm again. So we should be able to see that it has dropped a few files. I think if you notice that you have a file called loveletterforyou.txt.vbs in your Windows system file, that it's not actually a love letter, but that's just me. And if we refresh the Windows folder, it also dropped itself here. If we scroll down quite a bit, where is it? There it is. win32dll.vbs, also the worm. So it drops itself to quite a few places on your computer. And if we look, it didn't actually overwrite your MP3s, unlike the other files. Excuse me. If we show it, it made the original MP3 hidden. So you can still play it and everything, all your MP3s are safe, but it just overwrote the file name and hid the original. So you'd have to know that in order to recover your MP3s, but all the other files that it overwritten are lost. So I don't know why we're stuck on this cursor, but whatever. Anyway, due to its easily modified nature, you can look down, you can change a lot of things about this. And there were hundreds of variants of people doing just this. So we can make this incredibly destructive by changing JS to EXE to be overwritten, or JSE to COM. So now those files will be overwritten instead. And then it has some MIRC spreading routines. And then if we scroll down, here is the mail routine. We can change it to say anything. This is a worm. So when we run it again, it'll now overwrite all of these files. If we refresh, we should see that it has begun. Yes, as you can see, a lot of VBS files have been written to the system. So restarting would probably be a bad idea, but that's half the fun of these videos. So we're gonna go ahead and restart the computer. And it should not boot. If it restarts, there it goes. And nope, it's been overwritten, it will not boot. So you'd have to reinstall Windows if you got hit with a variant like this, since they can be incredibly destructive. So that is about it for the Love Letter Worm on its 12th anniversary.